Just weeks before the election, President Trump and First Lady Melania Trump have tested positive for coronavirus. This diagnosis has shocked the country, turning the presidential election on its head and leaving various questions about the future of the election. After the president's aide, Hope Hicks, tested positive for COVID-19, the president attended a private fundraiser in New Jersey, held a rally in Minnesota, and shared the first 2020 presidential debate stage with Democratic nominee Joe Biden. During the debate, he made remarks about Vice President Biden's excessive use of a mask, commenting, quote, "I don't wear a mask like him. Every time you see him, he's got a mask," end quote. Yet, days after the debate, on October 2nd, President Trump announced his and Melania's diagnosis via Twitter, assuring the country that, quote, "We will get through this together," end quote. With mild symptoms, Trump received treatment at Walter Reed National Military Medical Center and has since been discharged. Now he will be at the White House for the rest of his recovery. While multiple White House staff members have tested positive for COVID-19, Joe Biden and his wife Jill Biden have tested negative, as well as his running mate Kamala Harris and Vice President Mike Pence. As to what this means for the upcoming election, everything is up in the air. With two presidential debates left, Trump's battle with coronavirus has brought fresh uncertainty into the race. Whether the future debates are held virtually or postponed, Trump's diagnosis confirms one thing: the COVID-19 pandemic is far from over. For The Cut, I'm Maria Staubs.